I'm Scott, I'm from Pickering. Today we're going to do some dragon boat technique tips, and we're going to talk about leg drive. Leg drive is a huge aspect of the dragon boat stroke, and lots of athletes have questions as to how to do it properly. So we're going to try to give you a bit of guidance on that today. I'll start with a story. Adam Vancouverden, Canadian Olympic sprint kayaker. One of the most decorated Canadian Olympians of recent memory. I went to a talk by Adam in recent years, and a direct quote from Adam was, "It doesn't matter how hard I train, my arms will never be as big as my legs. Therefore, I use my legs to the maximum." Okay? And yes, this is one of the things that separates Adam from the field. He's extremely fit, and he uses every ounce of his body to get him to that finish line. So we're gonna try to do that as dragon boaters. We're gonna try to use every part of our body. And I want you to think about the dragon boat stroke like riding a bike. I want you to think about the image of cycling through your legs. What one leg is doing, the other leg is doing the opposite. One leg goes down, the other leg goes up. That's what I'm going to demonstrate here today. Okay, 2 feet forward, leg cycling. I want the paddling side leg mirroring the paddle. Paddle presses, leg presses. Paddle loads, leg loads. Paddle presses, leg presses. Paddle releases or loads or sets up. Leg releases, loads, sets up. Paddle stretches, leg stretches. They mirror each other. If anything, the leg press is milliseconds ahead of the paddle press. Opposite leg, quite simply, does the opposite. It does the opposite of this leg, thereby cycling. Let's demonstrate. Press through our heel. We only have a small heel press in the dragon boat. Let's get that pressure coming from the heel. Second point of connection is here on the seat. Let's really press into our sit bone or just below our sit bone where we connect with the seat. Let's really use that as a point of connection to load our body, to create a concrete connection. Third point of connection is the water. Is the paddle entering the water? We want to load all of our weight through our heel, through our sit bone, through our concrete body, onto the paddle and drive through with absolute force, with connection, with a solid connection throughout our body. So, paddling side, very simple, mirrors or slightly leads the paddle. Show you that. Where the opposite leg becomes very effective is during the recovery. I get to the exit, I can use this heel to provide stability and support while I am reloading the paddling side leg and paddle. So during the snap, exit, recovery, the opposite side leg plays a pivotal role.
The third athlete in on this video wearing the long pants and paddling on the right side does an exceptional job of loading and leveraging through his paddling side leg. He reloads very quickly, stretches through his thigh, and with huge velocity explodes or presses through his heel to help him drive his stroke. That is the essence of his power, comes from his lower body. Here's a better look on his reverse angle. It's now the second paddler in with the long pants, and he reloads very quickly, and all of his body weight drives against the footboard, creating a very high velocity in his pull, getting all of his body weight connected to that paddle.
Rest of the time. That's how we want to paddle. 2 feet forward.